हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल बायोलॉजी है इजी वेयर लर्निंग इज फन एंड माय सेल्फ संहिता सरकार। टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द ह्यूमन डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम एंड इन टुडेज वीडियो वी विल ओनली गेट फेमिलियर विद डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ ह्यूमन डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम। नाउ यू माइट बी थिंकिंग दैट व्हाट इज ह्यूमन डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम, सो बिफोर दैट वी मस्ट नो व्हाट इज डाइजेशन एंड हाउ Human digestive system helps in digestion of food. Digestion can be defined as the process of conversion of large complex and insoluble organic molecules into simpler, smaller and soluble molecules. यानि कि जो digestion की प्रक्रिया है, इससे क्या होता है कि जो complex food particles होते हैं या large food particles होते हैं, उनको simpler form में, soluble form में convert किया जाता है। और ये इसीलिए पॉसिबल हो पाता है क्योंकि हमारे बॉडी में एक डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम है जो कि एलिमेंट्री कैनल और उसके साथ एसोसिएटेड जो डिफरेंट डाइजेस्टिव ग्लैंड्स है उनकी मदद से ही पॉसिबल हो पाता है। देयर आर 5 स्टेप्स इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन इन एनिमल्स एंड दीज आर इंजेशन वेयर वी टेक इन फूड, डाइजेशन। In this process, the food containing large insoluble molecules is broken down into small water-soluble molecules. Then comes absorption, where the digested food passes through the intestinal wall into bloodstream. In the process of assimilation, the absorbed food is taken in by body cells and used for energy growth and repair. And in the last step, that is egestion, it is a process in which the undigested food is removed from the body. Now, let's try to identify different parts of digestive system. For that, I will use highlighter so that it becomes easy for you to identify the different parts of digestive system. Alimentary canal starts with mouth and ends in anus. As you can see, that mouth is also known as oral cavity or buccal cavity. The floor of the buccal cavity has a tongue bearing taste buds, which helps us to identify different tastes of food, and we have teeth that are present in our both the jaws. Now the teeth are of 4 types, that is incisor, that is used for biting, then canine, that is used for tearing flesh, and premolars and molars for grinding food particles. Now mouth leads to a portion called pharynx. It is a short conical region that lies after the mouth cavity. The pharynx are divided into 2 parts, the nasopharynx, which lies behind the nasal cavities, and the oropharynx, which lies behind the mouth. Pharynx leads to esophagus, which is shown here. It is also known as food pipe. It is a long, narrow muscular tube which leads to the stomach, which is shown here. Stomach, okay? You can identify stomach as you can see that it appears like J alphabet. It lies below the diaphragm on the left side of abdominal cavity and is J-shaped. It is divisible into cardiac and pylori part. The food is stored and partly digested in the stomach. As you can see that the stomach is situated on the left side of abdominal cavity. This part is called abdominal cavity. Okay, and you can see in human body we have 2 sides. This portion is the left part of human body and this portion is the right part of human body. So the stomach is situated on the left portion of abdominal cavity. Now the stomach leads to a highly coiled structure called small intestine, which also has 3 different parts, which is shown here. The first part is duodenum, which appears like C. It is the beginning of small intestine. Then we have jejunum. It is a super coiled or highly coiled structure, as you can see here. As there is limited space and the pipe, that is small intestine, is long in length, so it has to adjust in this compact space. That's why it is highly coiled. And the last portion of small intestine is ileum, which is the end part of small intestine. Here we have finger-like projections called villi. It increases the surface area of small intestine and maximum absorption of food occurs here only. Okay, now this small intestine leads to an inverted U-shaped structure called large intestine. As you can see, it appears like inverted U, right? So this is our large intestine. Why it is termed as large intestine? Because it is wider as compared to small intestine, and it is named so. That is, small intestine is named so because it is narrower as compared to large intestine. Large intestine has different parts. As you can see here, that we have a blind sac-like portion. It is termed as cecum. Then we have ascending colon. It is the part like this. It is ascending. So it is termed as ascending colon. Then we have transverse colon. Then we have transverse colon. It is this region. It is this region, transverse colon. And we have descending colon, which descends like this. So it is the descending colon. Descending colon. And large intestine ends in a part called anus, as I have already told you. And here you can see a region called rectum. Here the undigested food particles remain till we feel the urge to defecate. Now you can see another organ which is labeled here as appendix. It is of no use in human body. It is a vestigial organ. So through anal canal the feces passes. I hope it is quite clear to you till now. Now let's talk about the associated digestive glands that are present with our alimentary canal. Now the first one is salivary glands. Now it has got three different kinds, that is parotid gland, sublingual gland and submandibular gland. Okay, so as we know that in our saliva we have an enzyme called salivary amylase, which helps in the digestion of carbohydrates, right? So here partial digestion of food occurs. Then the next associated gland is liver. Here it is shown, liver. It has got two lobes. This one is the small lobe and this is the large lobe. Along with that we have gallbladder. So liver produces bile juice and it sends it to gallbladder, where it remains stored. When it is required, gallbladder releases bile juice in the small intestine. And the last associated gland linked with digestive systems is pancreas, which is located here. It is behind the stomach, so it is partially visible. As you can see, it is visible here, and behind the stomach is shown in a quite hazy manner. So this is our human digestive system. So आपको ये वीडियो कैसा लगा आप ज़रूर कमेंट करके मुझे बताइएगा. If you like this video, then please hit the like button. If you are new to my channel, then do subscribe to my channel and do not forget to press the bell icon for latest updates. Till then, take care and keep learning in a fun and easy way with Biology Hai Easy.